Thank you all for coming.
Dakle, hvala vam svi što ste došli.
And thank you ladies for coming.
I ženama isto hvala što ste došli na
tezinu. How many of you men are married?
Koliko od vas ima oženjenih?
Oh. Okay.
Everyone.
Okay,
everyone. In Zoomland.
Okay, the reason I say that is because I want the ladies to hear this also.
Ja bih volio da I mateži ovo čuju isto.
So Karl Marx, he said, no revolution is ever successful without the participation of the women.
Karl Marx je rekao, nijedna revolucija nije uspjela bez učešća žena.
And that's what we're trying to do here, is to create a spiritual revolution.
I ono, to je ono što mi želimo stvoriti ovdje, duhovnu revoluciju.
Or, as I stated in my book, to start the Hare Krishna movement again.
To je rat da bismo započeli Hare Krishna pokret ponovno.
I suppose you all know me to some degree.
Ja pretpostavljam da me svi donekle poznajete.
And I know some of you to some degree.
I ja poznajem neke od vas do izvjesne mjere.
I understand there's a number of farmers in our midst.
Ovdje među nama ima nekoliko onih koji se bave poljodjelstvom.
Huh? Who's that?
Farmeri.
Who else? Somebody there? Yes.
Neko online.
Bhakti Prabhu is there.
Da, da, ima okay. Tam Bhakti Prabhu isto.
All right, all glories to the farmers.
Slava farmerima.
Yeah. Yeah, tonight I want to speak to you about what I mean when I say start the Hare Krishna movement again.
Večeras vam želim govoriti na temu što ja mislim o tome kada kažem da trebamo započeti Hare Krishna pokret ponovno.
Because this is very confusing when many devotees hear that.
Jer za mnoge bhakte to zvuči veoma zbunjujuće.
So all of us come to Krishna consciousness in a very unique way.
Svi smo mi došli u pokret za svjesnost Krišne na veoma specifičan način.
We all have a unique experience.
Imamo specifična iskustva.
And those of us who came when Prabhupada was with us, we had a very, very different experience then.
I mi koji smo se pridružili u pokret dok je Šrila Prabhupada bio sa nama, imali smo sasvim različita iskustva.
So how many of you came between 77 and 85.
Koliko od vas je došlo pokret svjesnosti Krišne od 77. godine do 85.
Okay, 85 to 90?
Od 85. do 90.
Okay. And 90 to 95?
Od 90. do 95.
I suppose there's some in there.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, it's important to understand what Krishna consciousness was when Srila Prabhupada was with us.
Bitno je da znamo kakva je bila svjesnost Krišne kad je Srila Prabhupada bio sa nama.
So to do that I'm going to have to take you back, try to convey to you what was going on in America in the 60s and 70s.
Da bih vam to dočarao, pokušat ću da vas vratim natrag da vidimo što je bilo u Americi 60. godina.
You may or may not know that history, but it's important to understand.
Možda ne poznate tu taj dio povijesti, ali bitno da znate.
In the 1960s, 1963, our president was assassinated.
63. godine predsjednik je bio ubijen.
1968, his brother was assassinated.
65. godine njegov brat je bio ubijen.
1972, I think it was, the leader of the black community, Martin Luther King, was assassinated.
72. godine vođa crnoputih Amerikanaca Martin Luther King je bio ubijen.
And the black people in America at that time, they wanted to have equal rights.
Crni ljudi iz Amerike u to doba htjeli su imati jednaka prava.
Very different from what's going on in the black community today.
Sasvim drugačije od onih koji se koji su sad zastupljeni u crnoj populaciji danas.
Because in that time the black people were definitely treated as second class citizens.
Jer u to vrijeme crni ljudi su bili tretirani kao drugoklasni građani.
So they were rioting in many of the big cities.
I oni su se bunili u mnogim velikim gradovima.
The Vietnam War was also going on, which was an unpopular war.
U to vrijeme je i bio u tijeku rat u Vijetnamu koji je bio veoma nepopularan.
Many young people and old people were marching in the street protesting Vietnam.
Mnogi mladi ljudi pa i stariji su marširali ulicama i protestirali protiv rata u Vijetnamu.
I started going to university in 1966.
Ja sam počeo ići u univerzitet 66. godine.
When I was going to university, all this strife was going on.
I svi ti košmari i nemiri su bili u tijeku kad sam ja bio na univerzitetu.
At the same time, the 60s was a time of rampant materialism.
60. godine su bile godine galopirajućeg materijalizma.
And the young people, they could see that they thought this materialism was empty and they didn't really want to have anything to do with it.
I mladi ljudi su vidjeli da je taj materijalizam bespredmetan i nisu htjeli imati nikakve veze s tim.
So they were protesting, they were unhappy protesting and they were looking for some alternative to modern civilization.
Protestirali su i tražili su za neku alternativu tadašnjeg suvremenog društva.
So this is the scene that Srila Prabhupada came into in 1965.
I to je scena na koju je Srila Prabhupada ukoračio 75. godine.
Perfect timing.
Savršeno vrijeme bilo.
And he went, of course, to the perfect place, the lower east side of Manhattan.
I on naravno on je otišao na savršeno mjesto na Manhattanu u Njujorku koje se zove Lower East Side,
which was what they called the hip scene. Yeah, the real alternative people were there at the time.
U to vrijeme na tom mjestu to se zvala hip scena, ljudi alternativci koji su tražili nešto drugo, boravili su, bili su bazirani tamo.
And how much more alternative can you get than an Indian swami?
I kakvu veću alternativu možete dobiti od jednog indijskog svamija?
Who was promising to give them a genuine alternative to materialistic society.
I on im je obećao dati vjerodostojnu alternativu za materijalno društvo.
So the young people at that time, they were looking for revolution.
Mladi ljudi tog vremena su jednostavno gledali da budu za revolucijom.
They wanted change.
Htjeli su promjenu.
And spiritual change was even more than they could even have imagined.
A duhovna promjena je bila i više ono što su oni mogli očekivati.
So Srila Prabhupada's movement grew very, very quickly.
I Srila Prabhupadov pokret je narastao veoma brzo.
I came into contact with Prabhupada through his books in 1972.
Ja sam došao u kontakt s Prabhupadovim knjigama 72. godine.
And after I graduated with my master's degree in 1973, I joined the temple.
Nakon što sam diplomirao 73. godine, pridružio sam se hramu.
And we were at that time we were in a war with Maya.
I u to vrijeme mi smo bili u ratu sa Majom.
And we were going to win.
I mi ćemo pobijediti.
We were determined. We knew we were going to win.
Mi smo bili odlični, znali smo da ćemo biti pobjednici.
Because we're on God's side.
Jer smo bili na pravoj strani.
Bože.
Kako? Aha, na Božje strani, okay.
Or God was on our side.
Ili Bog je bio na našoj strani.
Same thing. So, we felt like that. We were on a war footing.
Znači, mi smo bili spremni za rat.
And so we would wake up in the morning, do the whole morning program, load the vans or the cars full of books and go out to distribute Prabhupada's message.
Probudili bi se ujutro, nakrcali bi kombije sa Prabhupadovim knjigama i s velikim entuzijasmom išli da širimo Prabhupadovu poruku.
So, revolution.
Dakle, revolucija.
Then in 1974, Prabhupada gave a series of morning walk lectures, a series of morning walk discussions in Vrindavan.
I 74. godine Srila Prabhupada je dao veoma značajan govor tijekom jedne jutarnje šetnje u Vrindavanu.
On the subject of World War III.
Na temu Treći svjetski rat.
Now remember at that time, you were all in a communist country.
U to vrijeme svi ste vi bili u komunističkoj državi.
And America was more of a godly country, much more godly than it is now.
I u to vrijeme Amerika je bila puno pobožnija nego što je sad.
So Prabhupada was he was not against this war.
I Srila Prabhupada nije bio protiv trećeg svjetskog rata.
He said yes, these communists must be finished. The atheistic communists must be finished.
I Srila Prabhupada je tom prilikom rekao da ti ateistički komunisti moraju biti uklonjeni.
And he told all the temples that they should get farms.
I on je rekao svim hramovima da trebaju nabaviti i osnovati farme.
And that when World War III was going to break out, the Pujaris would have dreams to take the deities from the city to the farms.
I kad je bila prijetnja da se da započne treći svjetski rat, puđari je jedan ili nekoliko puđara, sad ne znam, su sanjali da trebaju božanstva maknuti iz gradova na farme.
So we were taking this all very, very seriously.
I mi smo to shvatili zaista ozbiljno.
So not only about the revolution, but about not only about the revolution, but the alternative way of living, and specifically alternative way of living on the farm after everything was destroyed.
I mi smo veoma to ozbiljno shvatili, ne samo rat, nego i revoluciju u kojoj smo bili uključeni i život na farmama kao alternativu nakon što je sve uništeno.
So what happened?
I što se dogodilo?
What happened to the revolution?
Što se dogodilo revoluciji?
Fizzled out.
Razoružena revolucija.
Yeah, so by and by who?
I tko je to napravio?
That's the question.
E, sad to je pitanje.
This book is my answer to what happened to the Hare Krishna movement.
Ova moja knjiga je odgovor na to što se dogodilo Hare Krishna pokretu.
Our very transcendental Hare Krishna movement.
Našem transcendentalnom Hare Krishna pokretu.
We tasted transcendence then.
Mi smo tada kušali transcendenciju.
It is conspicuous by its absence now.
I ta transcendencija sad se jednostavno ne može osjetiti.
Where did it go?
Gdje je otišla?
So, that's what we're going to talk about a little bit.
I malo ćemo govoriti o tome.
The one thing you must keep in mind, that's the foundation for everything we understand in the world today.
Molim vas, imajte u umu što je temelj za sve što mi imamo ovdje danas u svijetu.
Razumijevanje
svega što imamo u svijetu.
This world is controlled by demons.
Ovaj svijet kontroliraju demoni.
And maybe since COVID you've got a much more complete understanding of what that means.
Još od vremena COVID-a imate malo potpunije razumijevanje što to znači.
When we say demons, Prabhupada described them. Prabhupada described these demons.
Šla Prabhupada je, kad spominjemo demone, Šla Prabhupada ih je opisivao.
He said man-eating rakshasas.
On je rekao rakshase koji jedu ljude.
They like to drink children's blood.
Oni vole piti dječju krv.
None of us could imagine how true that was.
Niko od nas nije mogao zamisliti koliko je to bilo istinito.
We were thinking like, you know, the pages of the Bhagavatam, all the wars between the demons and the devotees, this was ancient history.
Mi smo mislili kad smo čitali Bhagavatam, svi oni ratovi između demona i polubogova, to je neka drevna povijest.
Sorry.
Oprostite, ali ne.
It's going on now.
To se još uvijek odvija.
And we're living the current chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
I mi jednostavno živimo u jednom poglavlju Srimad Bhagavatama.
And this war between the Devas and the Asuras is going on in earnest.
Rat između Deva i Asura se upravo odvija.
But let me say, the Asuras are very much in earnest in this war to destroy God.
Asure su veoma žude za tim da unište Boga.
But the devotees? Are the devotees in the battle?
Jesu bhakte u bitci?
Are they in the fight?
Da li se oni bore?
Yeah. Right. Why?
Zašto?
Because we look at the world today, and if my little part of the world is okay, then everything is okay.
mi pogledamo u svijet napolje i ako moj mali dio svijeta u redu, znači sve u redu.
Despite the fact that 1 million children are disappearing every year somehow, without explanation.
Unatoč činjenici da oko milion djece svake godine bez ikakvog objašnjenja jednostavno nestane.
My kids are here. My kids are here. My children are here.
Kao moja djeca su ručak.
Ne, u redu su.
U redu.
Tu su.
Aha. Moja djeca su tu.
You're translating. What else? I've got enough money in the bank and I've got a house over my head, so the fact that there's millions of homeless people, well, too bad. That's the way the world works, you know.
I možemo misliti, moja kuća je u redu, moja obitelj u redu, imam na bankovnom računu puno. Da, u svijetu ima puno beskućnih ljudi, ali dobro, takav je svijet.
I don't have to go through the whole list with you, you know exactly what's going on.
Sad ja ne moram ići kroz čitavu listu, vi točno znate što se odvija.
And so the devotees are not engaged.
Tako da bhakte nisu uključeni.
They're not taking it as their own personal responsibility to save the world.
I bhakte ne uzimaju to kao osobnu odgovornost da spase svijet.
Have you read Prabhupada? He said, save all of them, and if you can't save all of them, save as many as you can.
Srila Prabhupada je rekao, spasite svakog, ali ako ne možete spasiti svakoga, spasite što više možete.
He said that. So who's making that their personal responsibility?
Ko je preuzeo tu osobnu odgovornost?
Why not?
Zašto ne?
That's your marching orders.
To je kako zapovjed, da.
And so like any army, there's many jobs that have to be done.
I kao u svakoj armiji ima puno posla što treba odraditi.
And we should figure out what's our job in this revolution.
I mi trebamo shvatiti koji je naš posao u ovoj revoluciji.
And make that the focus of the rest of our lives.
I to da učinimo fokusom ostatka našeg života.
If we do that, we can start the Hare Krishna movement again.
Ako to učinimo, onda možemo započeti Hare Krishna pokret ponovo.
Yeah, that's what it means.
To što znači.
So, we have a lot of devotees. There's more devotees outside of ISKCON now than there are inside.
Ima puno bhakta. Ima više bhakta izvan ISKCON-a nego što su sad u ISKCON-u.
So, let's unite them. Let's work together and do what? Do exactly what Srila Prabhupada told us to do.
Hajde da se svi ujedinimo i da napravimo ono što je Srila Prabhupada očekivao od nas.
How's that for a concept?
Kako vam zvuči taj koncept?
Yes.
You think so?
Jel' tako?
Okay. To reinforce that idea of the asuras and what they're up to, I want to read a little bit from Srila Bhakti Siddhanta's article Putana.
Da bi vam malo objasnio o tome što znači pravi asura, pročitat ću vam iz jednog teksta koji je Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Maharaj napisao u Putani.
Oh, I don't need that. I'm good. So, maybe you've all heard this under the title organized religion. It also circulates with that title.
Možda ste već čuli za ovaj tekst pod nazivom organizirana religija.
This is published in the Harmonists in 1932 and it was titled Putana.
32. godine Šla Prabhupada je to izdao u Harmonistu pod nazivom Putana.
So how are we going to do this with translation? Because this language is a little challenging, as you know.
Yeah, I can.
Okay.
You know, Sasha, I said to do.
No, it's okay.
Okay, what I'll do is I'll read the English and I'll give you the book.
Okay.
Sri Krishna manifests his eternal birth. Sri Krishna manifests his eternal birth, the pure cognitive essence of the serving soul who is located above all mundane limitations. first sentence.
Sri Krishna manifestira svoje vječno rođenje čistom kognitivnom esencijom služeće duše koja je smještena iznad svih svjetovnih ograničenja.
King Kamsa is a typical aggressive empiricist, it means atheist, ever on the lookout for the appearance of the truth for the purpose of suppressing him before he has time to develop.
Kralj Kamsa je tipični agresivni empirijski znanstvenik koji vječno traži pojavu istine sa svrhom da je potisne prije, da ga potisne kao svevišnju božansku osobu prije nego što ona ima vremena da se razvije.
So the demons who are in control of this world, they're looking for the manifestation of God, and as soon as they see it, they want to smash it.
Znači, demoni koji kontroliraju ovaj svijet, oni traže manifestaciju Boga i čim se ona pojavi, oni je žele uništiti.
So, then he engages the putanas.
Zatim on angažira putane.
Kamsa is persuaded that faith in the transcendental can be effectively put down by materialism if prompt and decisive measures are adopted at the very outset.
Kamsa je snažno uvjeren da se vjera u transcendentalno može efikasno ugasiti empirijskom znanošću ako se brze i odlučne mjere usvoje na samom početku.
So as soon as the God appears, smash him.
Čim se Bog pojavi, mi ga trebamo zdrobiti.
When Krishna is born, he is found to be able to upset all of their sinister designs.
Kada se Krishna rodi, vidi se da je on sposoban uznemiriti sve njihove opake planove.
So these are not problems for Krishna.
To nisu za Krishnu problemi.
Even though the demons, they think they can stop God, Krishna has no problem with them.
Iako demoni misle da oni mogu zaustaviti Krishnu, Krishna s njima nema problema.
So, Kamsa has his agents, one of which is the putanas.
Dakle, Kamsa ima svoje agente, a neki od njih su putane.
And the putanas, they are like putana witch, they are the killer of the babies.
A putane su poput vještice putane, ubojice djece.
So what do parents do when their baby is born? They take the baby to the church to be baptized.
I što roditelji čine čim se dijete rodi? Oni ga nose u crkvu da bude kršteno.
The baby, when he or she comes out of the mother's womb, falls at once into the hands of the pseudo teachers of religion.
Dijete, kada on ili ona izađe iz majčine utrobe, odmah pada u ruke pseudo učitelja religije.
The teachers are successful in preventing the attempts of the good preceptor,
like teacher,
whose help is never sought by the atheists of the world. Stop there.
Ti učitelji su uspješni u tome da spriječe pokušaje dobrih učitelja čiju pomoć nikada ne traže ateisti.
This is ensured by the arrangement of all the established churches of this world.
To je osigurano aranžmanima svih etabliranih crkva u ovom svijetu.
They have been successful in only supplying the watchful putanas for effecting the spiritual destruction of persons from the moment of their birth.
Oni su uspješni samo u tome što stvaraju putane koje budno paze for the spiritual, koje budno paze kako bi duhovno uništile ljude još od rođenja, odnosno odmah od rođenja.
With the cooperation of their worldly parents.
U suradnji sa njihovim svjetovnim roditeljima.
Now here's the point. No human arrangement can prevent the Putanas from obtaining possession of the pulpits.
What is a pulpit?
Pulpit, the place in the church where the priest speaks.
Aha, okay. Nijedan ljudski aranžman ne može spriječiti te Putane da ih se makne sa crkvene govornice.
This is due to the atheistic disposition of the people of this world.
To je zbog ateističkih sklonosti ljudi ovoga svijeta.
Now here's a very important statement.
Ovo je jako važna izjava.
The church that has the best chance of survival in this world is the damned in this damned world is that of atheism in the convenient disguise of religion.
Crkva koja ima najbolju šansu za preživjeti u ovom prokletom svijetu je ateizam koji se prerušio u teizam, odnosno religiju.
The churches.
To su crkve.
In the atheism and convenient disguise of religion.
Ateizam u prikladnoj krinki teizma, odnosno vjere u Boga.
The churches have always proved to be the staunchest upholders of the grossest form of worldliness.
Crkve su se pokazale da su najsnažniji održavatelji najgrubljih oblika svjetovnosti.
Which even the worst criminals are found, from which the worst criminals are found to recoil.
Od kojih se čak i najgori kriminalci klone ili zgražaju, da.
Okay. I hope you're getting this because the language is not very easy.
Nadam se da ovo uspijevate uhvatiti jer jezik kojim je pisano nije baš lak.
And he continues here, no stable religious arrangement for instructing the masses has yet been successful.
Nijedan stabilan aranžman za poučavanje masa još uvijek nije bio uspješan.
This means for the masses this means that there can be no mass movement of transcendence.
To znači da ne može biti masovnog pokreta transcendencije.
Let's see. This is too difficult to. However, the it's too difficult. Okay. So the idea of an organized church in an intelligible form indeed marks the close of the living spiritual movement.
Ideja organizirane crkve u prepoznatljivom obliku uistinu označava kraj živućeg duhovnog pokreta.
So, the organized church.
Organizirana crkva.
This is why this paper is sometimes called organized religion.
Zato se ovaj rad zove organizirana religija.
Organized church in the modern form is the close of the living spiritual movement.
Organizirana crkva u ovakvom obliku je kraj živućeg duhovnog pokreta.
And it indicates the end of the absolute guidance of the bona fide spiritual teacher.
I ona indicira kraj
indicate the end of the
indicira kraj apsolutnog i nekonvencionalnog vodstva koje bona fide, odnosno u dobroj vjeri duhovni učitelj, vjerodostojni duhovni učitelj daje.
So the situation is not lost.
situacija nije izgubljena.
Because he goes on to explain that the bona fide spiritual master is not bound by any convention.
Jer dalje on objašnjava da vjerodostojni duhovni učitelj nije ograničen nikakvom konvencijom.
Convention. This is the way it must be done.
Nikakvim ograničenjem ovako se to mora raditi.
The bona fide spiritual master is not bound by such rules.
Vjerodostojni duhovni učitelj nije ograničen takvim pravilima.
Why? Because he's acting from the instruction of super soul from within.
Zašto? Jer djeluje prema naputku nad duše iznutra.
And he has many unconventional methods that he can employ according to time, place and circumstance.
I ima mnoge nekonvencionalne metode koje može koristiti prema vremenu, mjestu i okolnostima.
So, this tells us a little bit about the demons and their influence in modern religion.
Ovo nam govori nešto o demonima i njihovom utjecaju u modernoj religiji.
Of course, this is from our acharya, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta.
Ovo je od našeg acharya, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta.
So he's saying, the church that has the best chance of survival is atheism and the convenient disguise of religion.
Znači on kaže crkva koja ima najveće izglede da preživi je ateizam u prikladnoj krinci teizma.
So understanding that we might be on the lookout to see how that is taking place.
Pošto ovo razumijemo, trebamo pogledati kako se to odvija.
And I've heard that the Catholic churches now, above the altar, they have the triangle with the all-seeing eye in it.
Čuo sam da sada katoličke crkve iznad oltara imaju trokut u kojem se nalazi svevideće oko.
And maybe you've heard some of the demonic things that the Pope is doing.
Možda ste vidjeli neke demonske stvari koje Papa radi.
Very, very strange.
Jako, jako čudno.
So that's certainly going on there.
To se definitivno događa.
And there's certainly going on many other places as well.
I definitivno se događa na mnogim drugim mjestima.
And how can we understand that?
I kako to možemo razumjeti?
Because atheism and the demonic influence is increasing all over the Western world.
Jer ateizam i demonski utjecaj se povećavaju diljem zapadnog svijeta.
Hypersexualization of children.
Hiperseksualizacija djece.
Complete abandonment of all morality.
Potpuno napuštanje svakog morala.
To the point where a person who espouses or encourages morality is condemned.
Do točke gdje supružnik koji podržava moral biva osuđen.
So the demons, at least in the West, they appear to be making great progress.
Čini se da demoni barem na zapadu čine velik napredak.
And you know, I see it's ironic for me that how I perceived my country when I was a child has become what we perceived the Soviet Union to be, and at least Russia, if not, you know, the greater the independent states organization of, you know, Russian states, they have become what America used to be.
Ok, ironično je za mene da kada sam ja odrastao vidio sam Rusiju, odnosno SSSR, kao negativan, a sada Ameriku vidim na isti negativan način kako sam tada vidio SSSR.
Yeah, they have criminalized LGBTQ plus in Russia.
oni su učinili LGBTQ plus pokret kriminalnim u Rusiji.
Thank you.
Hvala vam.
They're defending morality.
Oni brane moral.
So it's very strange to me to understand. I don't know how that happened, but it's a great mystery for me.
Ne znam kako se to dogodilo, to je velika misterija za mene.
Anyway, that's the situation that we're in the world today.
To je situacija u kojoj se sada nalazi svijet.
Now, talking about atheism in the form of religion.
A sada kad pričamo o ateizmu u obliku religije.
My conviction is that ISKCON, that the demons who run the world, they were able to understand that Prabhupada and his movement presented a great threat to the world very early in the 60s and 70s.
Ja sam čvrsto uvjeren da demoni koji vladaju svijetom su shvatili da je Srila Prabhupadov pokret predstavljao veliku prijetnju već u 60. i 70.
And that our movement was infiltrated from many different places during that time.
I da je naš pokret infiltriran sa mnogih različitih mjesta u to vrijeme.
And for what purpose?
S kojim ciljem?
To maintain the status quo.
Kako bi se održao status quo, stanje kakvo jest.
The demons who run the world, they take a lot of trouble to maintain the status quo.
Demoni koji vladaju svijetom se puno muče kako bi održali taj status quo.
And for that purpose they infiltrate everybody.
I s tim ciljem oni infiltriraju sve.
Russia, the Soviet Union, they were infiltrating everybody, so was America and probably many other countries.
Rusija i Amerika i vjerojatno i mnoge druge države su isto tako infiltrirale se svuda.
And it was very interesting for me as I traveled from 2005 to 2015, many devotees would come to me and tell me how their country was infiltrated and their experience of that.
Kada sam putovao 2005. do 2015. Mnogi bakte bi mi prilazili i govorili bi mi na koji način su se strane sile infiltrirale u njihovu zemlju.
Now, the infiltrators, they don't infiltrate to become the pot washers.
Oni koji se infiltriraju, njima nije cilj da postanu perači lonaca.
They need to have influence.
Oni trebaju utjecaj.
And they have infiltrated all the way up to the GBC.
I oni su se infiltrirali sve gore do GBC-a.
On my first visit to Russia, I met one Russian devotee who was in prison in the 80s.
Kad sam bio u Rusiji, posjetio sam jednog ruskog baktu koji je bio u zatvoru u 80-ima.
And he was told that the Russians had infiltrated ISKCON all the way up to the position of the GBC from New York.
I njemu je bilo rečeno da su se Rusi infiltrirali u ISKCON sve do razine GBC-a i to iz New Yorka.
And I give many other examples of such stories in my book.
I dajem još puno primjera takvih priča u svojoj knjizi.
So, is it true?
Je li to istina?
How can we understand?
Kako to možemo razumjeti?
So Prabhupada used an expression frequently, phalena parichyate.
Prabhupada je često koristio izraz phalena parichyate.
Phalena means result, parichyate you can judge by, judging by the result.
To znači suditi po rezultatima.
So, what's the result of the history of our Hare Krishna movement, especially since Prabhupada has left?
Koji je rezultat povijesti našeg Hare Krishna pokreta, pogotovo od kad je Prabhupada otišao?
And my observation is that if our enemies had wanted to destroy us, they could not have done a better job than our own leaders.
Moja observacija je da ako su nas naši neprijatelji htjeli uništiti, nisu to mogli učiniti bolje nego što su to učinili naši vođe.
And we were seeing that even as early as the mid 80s.
I to smo vidjeli već u sredinom 80-ih.
Prabhupada told them over and over and over again Don't change my books.
Prabhupada mi je stalno iznova govorio, ne mijenjajte moje knjige.
What did they do? In 1983, they published Bhagavad Gita with over 5,000 changes.
A što su napravili u 83. objavili su Bhagavad Gitu sa više od 5,000 izmjena.
And it's the policy of the BBTI that all of the international translations should be done from the changed books.
I to je politika je međunarodnog BBT-a da se svi prijevodi moraju raditi na uređenim, odnosno izmijenjenim knjigama.
And it's the policy of the GBC that only the changed books should be sold in ISKCON's temples.
I politika je GBC-a da se samo te izmijenjene knjige mogu prodavati u ISKCON-ovim hramovima.
And in some temples they won't even allow the original books.
U nekim hramovima niti ne dozvoljavaju korištenje izvornih knjiga.
Does that sound like a sincere disciple?
Zvuči li vam to kao iskreni učenici?
Something's wrong with that picture.
Što ne valja s tim?
There's many, many other things that I go through in the book. Every, let's start over. In the book, I explained that every effort was made in every aspect of Krishna consciousness to destroy the faith of the followers.
U knjizi objašnjavam kako su učinjeni svi mogući napori u svim aspektima kako bi se uništila vjera u sljedbenicima.
And they've done a very good job.
I oni su napravili jako dobar posao s tim.
Of my god brothers that are still in the society or let's say in ISKCON, probably 98% of my god brothers and god sisters have left ISKCON.
Oko 98% mojih god bradera i god sisterica su napustile pokret.
Hopefully many of them are still practicing Krishna consciousness independently.
Nadam se da mnogi od njih i dalje prakticiraju svjesnost Krišne neovisno.
But we all know that if you're doing it on your own, it's a struggle.
Ali svi znamo da ako to činiš sam, da je to teško, to je teška borba.
Which is exactly why Prabhupada wanted to establish temples to give everyone a place to come and associate with others to talk and hear about Krishna.
I zato je Srila Prabhupada htio utemeljiti hramove da svi imaju mjesto gdje mogu doći i slušati i govoriti o Krišni.
So, so now we're at 45 years since Srila Prabhupada has left us.
I sada je prošlo 45 godina od kad nas je Srila Prabhupada napustio.
And many devotees who join in the 70s and even 80s, they say, this is not the ISKCON that I joined.
I mnogi bhakte koji su se pridružili u 70-ima, čak i 80-ima, kažu, ovo nije ISKCON u koji sam ja došao.
So, unfortunately, they've left, they voted with their feet and they've left one by one.
Nažalost, oni su glasovali sa svojim stopalima, tako što su otišli, jedan po jedan.
So, my position is, why one by one, let's join together and start the Hare Krishna movement again.
A moja pozicija, moj pogled je, zašto jedan po jedan, ajmo se svi skupiti zajedno i isponova pokrenuti Hare Krishna pokret.
And again, what does that mean? That means doing exactly what Srila Prabhupada told us to do.
A što to znači isponova, odnosno ponovno? To znači da trebamo raditi točno ono što nam je Srila Prabhupada rekao da radimo.
Now I want to explain to you some details about how we can do that and make it successful.
Želim vam objasniti neke detalje kako to možemo učiniti i da bude uspješno.
Srila Prabhupada gave the GBC very explicit instructions how he wanted ISKCON to be managed.
Srila Prabhupada je dao GBC-u veoma izričite upute kako žele da se ISKCON menadžira, odnosno vodi.
He wanted all of the temples to be independent.
Htio je da svi hramovi budu neovisni.
No centralization of anything except for the book printing.
Nema nikakve centralizacije ničega osim tiskanja knjiga.
There is a famous letter Srila Prabhupada wrote to Kurandar. Is it translated?
I have it in Croatian in my laptop.
Okay. So there's a famous letter Srila Prabhupada wrote to Kurandar, the very competent leader in Los Angeles, explaining no centralization of anything.
Postoji pismo, čak i na hrvatskom, Karandari, vrlo sposobnom lideru u Los Angelesu, u kojem Srila Prabhupada izričito kaže nema centralizacije ničega.
And, you know, Prabhupada created the GBC because he needed help. He wanted his GBC men to do what he was doing.
Prabhupada je utemeljio GBC jer mu je trebala pomoć i htio da ljudi iz GBC-a rade ono što je on radio.
What was Prabhupada doing?
A što je Prabhupada radio?
Traveling around the world from center to center.
Putovao diljem svijeta od centra do centra.
Giving classes, inspiring devotees.
Davao predavanja, inspirirao bakte.
Dealing with any problems that were there.
Nosio se s problemima.
Helping the temple president if he could.
Pomagao temple prezidentima ako je mogao.
And encouraging the devotees to chant their rounds and follow the principles.
I ohrabrivao bakte da mantraju krugove i slijede principe.
That's what Prabhupada was doing.
To je Prabhupada radio.
He did not micromanage.
On se nije bavio mikromanagementom.
In fact, this was the secret of Prabhupada's success. He gave the men who would take the responsibility for the temple, he gave them freedom to act on their own inspiration.
To je tajna Prabhupadovog uspjeha. Znači, ljudima koji bi se bavili hramom, on im je dao slobodu da rade po vlastitoj inspiraciji.
And because of that, qualified men would come because they could work according to their ability.
I zbog toga bi dolazili kvalitetni ljudi, odnosno kvalificirani ljudi, zato što bi oni mogli raditi prema svojim odlikama, sposobnostima.
He wasn't interested in yes men.
Njemu nisu ga zanimali klimači glavama.
He wanted capable men who could do the simple task of preaching, holding feasts, and distributing books.
Njega su zanimali sposobni ljudi koji su mogli odraditi jednostavne zadatke poput propovjedanja, održavanja fisteva i distribucije, odnosno dijeljenja knjiga.
Krishna consciousness is not rocket science.
Svjesnost Krišne nije nuklearna fizika.
Simple.
To je jednostavno.
Namahata program.
Namahata program.
Invite people to your house, give them prasadam, talk about Bhagavad Gita, have a kirtan.
Pozovi ljude k sebi doma, daj im prasadam, pričajte o Bhagavad Giti i imajte kirtan.
Do you need multiple layers of bureaucracy for that?
Trebate li više razina birokracije da biste došli do toga?
No.
Ne.
He told them, no bureaucracy. If you create bureaucracy, everything will be spoiled.
Rekao im je, bez birokracije, ako stvorite birokraciju, sve će biti pokvareno.
How many layers of bureaucracy do the GBC have now?
A koliko slojeva, odnosno razina birokracije, sad ima GBC?
11 or 12?
12.
12. We met with three of those layers the other day.
Mi smo se susreli sa tri te razine.
Three of your local layers of bureaucracy.
Tri lokalne razine birokracije.
So, why don't they do what Prabhupada said to do?
Zašto ne rade ono što im je Prabhupada rekao da rade?
Again and again and again in every aspect of the society they disobey Srila Prabhupada.
Opet i opet i opet i opet. U svakom aspektu društva oni su nisu postupili kako im je rekao Srila Prabhupada.
Now I'll give you one other one that's very, very significant.
Daću vam još jedan primjer koji je jako značajan.
Maybe you there's many I have one godbrother, Bhakti one of my godbrothers, Siddhanta Prabhu, has interviewed many devotees. Asking them to recount their pastimes with Prabhupada in the early days.
Jedan od mojih god bradera, Siddhanta Prabhu, je radio intervjue s mnogo ljudi kako bi saznao kako je bilo njima sa Srila Prabhupadom u ranim danima.
These are on YouTube.
To je na YouTube-u dostupno.
And many of the devotees stated that we had the sense of being a family.
I mnogi bhakte su rekli, mi smo imali osjećaj da smo obitelj.
There's no bureaucracy in a family.
Nema birokracije u obitelji.
We're all together, we're all helping each other, we're all serving each other.
Svi smo zajedno, svi si pomažemo i svi služimo jedni druge.
That was replaced. The GBC decided that they were going to change that.
Ali to je zamijenjeno. GBC je odlučio da će to promijeniti.
And they've created a hierarchical command control organization.
I napravili su hijerarhijsku organizaciju zapovjedi i kontrole.
That means like a corporation.
Kao u korporaciji.
You've got one person at the top. He gives command that affects many, many people below them.
Jedna osoba na vrhu daje zapovjedi koje utječu na mnoge ljude ispod.
This is called institution.
To se zove institucija.
Institutions are created by demons for control.
Institucije stvaraju demoni s ciljem kontrole.
You don't find any mention of institutions in the pages of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
Nema spomena institucije na stranicama Srimad Bhagavatama.
But they've now got the GBC on top.
Ali sad imaju GBC na vrhu.
And everybody has to pay allegiance, make a pledge of allegiance to the GBC.
I svi moraju dati zakletvu odanosti GBC-u.
If you want to take sannyas, you have to make a pledge of allegiance, not to Prabhupada, but to the GBC.
Znači, ako želite dobiti sannyas, morate položiti zakletvu ne Prabhupadu, nego GBC-u.
If you want to initiate disciples, you have to make a pledge of allegiance to the GBC.
Ako želite inicirati učenike, morate položiti zakletvu GBC-u.
And the GBC are consider themselves superior to the transcendental autocrat spiritual master.
A GBC se smatra da je iznad, oni sebe smatraju da su iznad transcendentalnog autokrata duhovnog učitelja.
So obviously a transcendental autocrat cannot be controlled by somebody else.
Očito je da transcendentalnog autokrata nitko drugi ne može kontrolirati.
If you want to take initiation, you have to take the course of becoming an ISKCON disciple.
Ako želite dobiti inicijaciju, morate proći tečaj da postanete ISKCON učenik.
And in that course it's reinforced again and again and again that you are becoming a disciple of the GBC.
I u tom tečaju se stalno ponavlja da vi postajete učenik GBC-a.
This is not Vaishnava Siddhanta.
O, to nije Vaishnava Siddhanta zaključak.
The GBC, they think they can create Siddhanta.
GBC misli da on može stvoriti Siddhantu, Siddhante.
Unfortunately, at least for a while, many devotees go along with it.
Nažalost, barem neko vrijeme, puno bhakta je jednostavno to prihvaćalo.
I'm not going along with it.
Ja to ne prihvaćam.
So I say, let's join together and start the Hare Krishna movement again.
Ja kažem, ajmo se ponovno skupiti i ponovno pokrenuti pokret svjesnosti Krišne.
Now, how are we going to avoid the problems that exist in ISKCON now? That's asked all the time. It's very important.
Kako ćemo izbjeći probleme koji trenutno muče ISKCON?
And that is that we create ISKCON the way Prabhupada wanted it to be.
Na način da ćemo stvoriti ISKCON kakav je Prabhupada htio da bude.
As a non-institutional organization.
Kao neinstitucionalizirana organizacija.
Okay. Yes, you can have some organization, some rules, but no top-down hierarchical command control.
može postojati organizacija i neka pravila, ali ne hijerarhijska kontrola od ozgo prema dolje.
So, what's that mean?
Što to znači?
That means everybody is representing only themselves.
To znači da svatko predstavlja samo sebe.
If you were a guru, you are not a representative of an institution.
Ako ste guru, onda niste predstavnik institucije.
And if you have problems, they don't have to hide them to protect the image of the institution.
I ako postoji neki problem, ne treba ga se sakriti da bi se zaštitio image institucije.
You have a problem. We're sorry. God bless you. We hope you do better.
Imaš problem, žao nam je. Nek te Bog blagoslovi i nadamo se da će ti biti bolje.
It doesn't affect anybody else.
Ne utječe na nikog drugog.
It doesn't specifically affect the principles that we are following.
I konkretno ne utječe na principe koje mi slijedimo.
Because that's the basis. The principles are sacrosanct. We follow them to the best we can. And maybe we have problem, but keep trying.
I to je, principi su svetinja, slijedimo ih najbolje što možemo, možda ćemo imati neke probleme, ali trebamo se i dalje truditi.
Neither is there any higher institutional big shots.
I nema velikih institucionalnih faca.
GBC, no GBC.
Nema GBC-a.
No regional secretary.
Nema regionalnih tajnika.
You don't need all those.
Ne trebate ih.
All those, this, what do they call them? Secretaries or whatever.
Deputies.
Deputies. You don't need all that stuff.
Sve te tajnike, zamjenike, ne trebate ništa od toga.
There can be some, Prabhupada said, if there's an issue, a group, a special group can be formed temporarily to solve the problem.
Prabhupada je rekao, ako postoji neki problem, može se privremeno oformiti neka grupa koja će riješiti taj problem.
After the problem is solved, no more group.
Nakon što je problem riješen, više te grupe nema.
Prabhupada told them that.
Prabhupada im je tako rekao.
But they wanted to make these groups permanent.
Ali oni su te grupe htjeli učiniti trajnima.
But we don't need that.
Ali to nam ne treba.
So, independent temples, no institution.
Neovisni hramovi, nema institucije.
Everybody represents only themselves.
Svatko predstavlja samo sebe.
Everybody can act according to their own inspiration without anybody else telling them no.
Svatko može djelovati prema vlastitoj inspiraciji bez da im netko drugi kaže ne.
If you want to start a temple, do it.
Ako želite napraviti hram, učinite to.
Nobody can say no.
Niko vam ne može reći ne.
The command is already given by Lord Chaitanya and Srila Prabhupada.
Zapovjedi su već dali Sri Chaitanya i Srila Prabhupada.
So, we have then freedom.
Tada imamo slobodu.
Freedom, which is very, very important.
Slobodu koja je jako važna.
So I want to speak a little bit about Prabhupada's management method.
Želim malo govoriti o Prabhupadovoj metodi rukovođenja, menadžmenta.
And why it's so important and why Prabhupada's management method helped ISKCON to explode all over the world in 10-11 short years.
Zašto je Prabhupadova metoda menadžmenta pomogla ISKCON-u da eksplodira diljem svijeta u 11-12 kratkih godina?
Now, Prabhupada used a method that was also used by somebody else, and I'm going to speak about that somebody else to give a more detailed example.
Prabhupada je koristio metodu koju je koristio i netko drugi, i sada ću tog nekog drugog spomenuti kako bi vam dao primjer.
That method is called chaotic. Chaos and order, the combination of chaos and order.
To je metoda kaosoredna, znači u njoj se sadrže i kaos i red.
Chaotic. Huh?
Yes.
It's a new word, so yes. You can just use it.
Yes.
Okay.
Chaotic, kaos i red, order je red.
New word for the Croatian dictionary. Combination of chaos and order.
Kombinacija kaosa i reda.
And what's the order is the instructions that Srila Prabhupada gave.
order, odnosno red, je, su upute koje je dao Srila Prabhupada.
And the chaos is all the inspired devotees acting to try to fulfill those orders to the best of their ability.
A kaos su svi oni inspirirani bhakte koji pokušavaju ispuniti te zapovjedi Srila Prabhupada u skladu sa svojim mogućnostima.
So, give you an example.
Daću vam primjer.
I joined ISKCON in 1974.
Ja sam se pridružio ISKCON-u 74.
73, I'm sorry.
73.
I had read the books before, some of the books before that.
Neke od knjiga sam pročitao prije toga.
But in 1976, just 3 years later, I opened my first temple.
Ali 76. samo 3 godine nakon toga otvorio sam svoj prvi hram.
Very wet behind the ears, practically, you know, completely inexperienced.
Bio sam, da tako kažem, balav, neiskusan.
But I was inspired, and I wanted to do that.
Ali bio sam inspiriran i želio sam to učiniti.
And we preached, we brought people, came for the Sunday feast, we distributed books, we had a wonderful time.
I propovjedali smo, ljudi su dolazili na Sunday feast, dijelili smo knjige i bilo nam je divno.
And nobody said no.
I niko nije rekao ne.
Many devotees did that.
I mnogi bhakte su to činili.
There's one devotee, Shivananda, he went to Germany. He didn't speak German. He went there alone, 19 years old I think he was, with no money.
Bio je jedan bhakta Shivananda koji je s 19 godina i bez prebijene pare u džepu otišao u Njemačku, a nije znao ni njemački.
Pretty bold young man.
Poprilično hrabar mladić.
And he was successful.
I bio je uspješan.
Yeah, the story is pretty amazing.
Da, priča je poprilično nevjerojatna.
There are many stories like that.
Postoje mnoge priče poput te.
Vishnu Jan Swami. Many of the Swamis.
Mnogi Swami.
They would just go and depend on Krishna, and Krishna would help them.
Oni bi jednostavno išli, ovisili bi o Krishni i Krishna bi im pomogao.
So we can do that again.
I to možemo učiniti ponovno.
If we have freedom.
Ako imamo slobodu.
And the only reason we don't have freedom is if we submit to a GBC or a GBC representative that wants to tell us what to do.
Jedini razlog zašto nemamo slobodu je zato što se podređujemo GBC-u ili njihovom predstavniku koji nam govori što da činimo.
Have you heard any stories about devotees who are preaching successfully and the GBC or their representatives come and stop them?
Yes.
Jeste li čuli priče o baktama koji uspješno propovijedaju i GBC ili njihov predstavnik dođe i jednostavno ih spriječi u tome?
Yes.
Yes.
Practically every head is going up and down.
Sve glave idu gore dolje.
I've heard stories like that from all over the world.
Ja sam čuo takve priče o širom svijeta.
From Africa, from America, from Europe.
Iz Afrike, Amerike, Europe.
Russia.
Rusije.
Why?
Zašto?
Oh, you're not authorized.
Niste autorizirani, ovlašteni.
Well, authorize them then.
Pa onda ih ovlastite.
Why not?
Zašto ne?
Just give them say you're authorized.
Pa dajte im onda ovlaštenje.
But they stop them.
Ali oni ih zaustave.
Which leads to my conclusion that they want to destroy Prabhupada's mission.
Što mene navodi na zaključak da oni žele uništiti Prabhupadovu misiju.
Falena paričijate.
Falena paričijate.
What other conclusion can you come to?
Do kojeg drugog zaključka možete doći?
When you see it again, again and again.
Kad to vidite opet i opet i opet.
So, freedom.
Dakle, sloboda.
So, okay, I got away. The example I was going to give you of chaotic.
Trebao sam vam dati primjer kaosoređa.
That term was created by the founder of the Visa credit card.
Taj termin je smislio utemeljitelj Visa kreditnih kartica.
Anybody have Visa credit card?
Ima li neko Visa karticu?
Okay. So, this is an amazing story.
To je nevjerojatna priča.
He was a manager of a small bank and he was asked to go join a group of bankers to try to create a credit card.
On je bio menadžer male banke i pozvan je da se udruži s ostalim menadžerima banaka da probaju stvoriti kreditnu karticu.
A universal credit card.
Univerzalnu kreditnu
karticu. Now at that time there was Diners Club and American Express.
Tada su postojali samo Diners Club i American Express.
Only two, maybe there's another one.
Možda još koja.
But they were very localized, they were not universal.
Bile su vrlo lokalizirane, nisu bile univerzalne.
So this fellow's name is D-Hawk.
Njegovo ime je D-Hawk.
And what he did was, he brought in a bunch of people with different ability.
On je skupio razne ljude s raznim sposobnostima.
And asked him to let's get together and solve this problem.
I rekao je ajmo se naći i riješiti taj problem.
Nobody had a title.
Niko nije imao titulu.
Nobody had any authority.
Niko nije imao autoritet.
They were just supposed to make their contribution to look and see where's the problem and can you contribute to solving the problem.
Svako je trebao samo dati svoj doprinos da vidi gdje je problem i možemo li pomoći u rješavanju problema.
So I'm going to read a little bit. So they were very successful.
Bile su jako uspješni.
Visa grew a minimum of 20% a year for 30 years.
Visa je rasla minimum 30% godišnje, minimum 20% godišnje 30 godina.
In some years as much as 50%.
A nekih godina je rasla čak i 50%.
This has never been equaled in the business world ever.
To nikad nije viđeno u svijetu biznisa.
No. So D-Hawk, he had a rule that he tried to apply.
D-Hawk je imao pravilo koje je pokušavao primijeniti.
And that is the truth. There is a truth that given the right conditions, from no more than dreams, determination, and liberty to try, quite ordinary people consistently do extraordinary things.
Postoji jedna osoba da pod pravim uvjetima, od snova, odlučnosti, i slobode da pokušaju, poprilično obični ljudi konzistentno čine izvanredne stvari.
Just like the early devotees.
Kao i rani bakte.
Like Shivananda.
Kao Shivananda.
Ordinary devotee.
Obični bakta.
No money, alone, goes to a foreign country, no language.
Bez novaca, sam odlazi u stranu zemlju, ne zna ni jezik.
Ordinary person doing extraordinary things.
Obična osoba koja čini izvanredne stvari.
Because he wanted to please Srila Prabhupada.
Jer je htio zadovoljiti Srila Prabhupada.
And he had the freedom to do so.
I imao je slobodu da to učini.
Okay, now, he goes, the book he wrote where I took this from is a wonderful book. If you get to see it, it's called The Creation of Chaotic, something like that.
Knjiga koju je napisao zove se Stvaranje kaosoređa.
So, I'll read just a little bit of this to give you a flavor of how things were going.
Malo ću samo pročitati da dobijete mali dojam.
Leaders spontaneously emerged and re-emerged.
Vođe su dolazili sami od sebe iznova i iznova.
Nobody was in control, but everything was in order.
Niko nije imao kontrolu, ali sve je bilo u redu.
Ingenuity exploded.
Domišljatost je eksplodirala.
Individuality and diversity flourished.
Individualnost i raznolikost su cvjetale.
People astonished themselves at what they could accomplish.
Ljudi su zapanjivali sami sebe time što su mogli postići.
And were amazed at the suppressed talents that emerged in others.
I bili su zadivljeni zatomljenim talentima koji su se ispoljavali iz drugih.
Position was meaningless.
Pozicija nije bila važna.
Power over others was meaningless.
Moć nad drugima nije bila važna.
Time was meaningless.
Vrijeme je bilo nevažno.
Excitement about doing the impossible exploded.
Uzbuđenje o tome da se radi nemoguće je eksplodiralo.
And a community arose based on purpose, principle and people.
I narasla je zajednica koja se temelji na svrsi, ljudima,
purpose, principle and people.
Svrsi, principima i ljudima.
Individuality, self-worth, ingenuity and creativity exploded.
Individualnost, samovrijednost, kreativnost i domišljatost su cvjetale.
And as they did, so did the sense of belonging to something larger than oneself.
A s njima je cvjetao i osjećaj da pripadaju nečem većem od samih sebe.
Something beyond everybody's concern for immediate and personal gain.
Nečem što je veće od svačije želje za osobnim dobitkom.
In the process our perception began to change.
U procesu naša se percepcija počela mijenjati.
It was as though we could now see with different eyes.
Kao da sada možemo vidjeti drugim očima.
Even more with a different mind.
I drugim umom.
Even beyond that,
čak i iznad toga,
with a different consciousness.
Sa različitom svjesnošću.
And it was incredibly exciting.
I to je bilo nevjerojatno uzbudljivo.
This is what we had in the early days of ISKCON.
To smo imali u ranim danima ISKCON-a.
Have any of you experienced it?
Je li netko od vas to iskusio?
A little bit?
Yes.
Bar malo?
Yes.
Okay, what happened?
I što se dogodilo?
Many people were joining ISKCON.
Mnogi ljudi su se pridruživali ISKCON-u.
Well, if it was like that, why aren't we still there?
Ako je bilo tako, zašto još uvijek nismo tamo?
It went away?
Otišlo je.
It went away somehow.
Otišlo je, nekako, za većinu ljudi.
So I don't want to spend time pointing at fingers at ISKCON or criticizing ISKCON.
Ne želim trošiti vrijeme upirući prstom ili kritizirajući ISKCON.
They will say I'm against ISKCON, but I am not against ISKCON.
Neki će reći da sam protiv ISKCON-a, ali ja nisam protiv ISKCON-a.
I'm against the GBC's ISKCON.
Ja sam protiv ISKCON-a koji pripada GBC-u.
And I am for Srila Prabhupada's ISKCON.
I ja sam za ISKCON koji pripada Srila Prabhupadu.
ISKCON has been my life. I love ISKCON.
ISKCON je bio moj život, ja volim ISKCON.
And ISKCON can save this world.
I ISKCON može spasiti ovaj svijet.
Srila Prabhupada's ISKCON.
Srila Prabhupadov ISKCON.
So when I say start the Hare Krishna movement again, this is what I'm talking about.
Kad kažem započnimo Hare Krishna pokret isponova, o tome pričam.
And we have a lot of work to do.
I čeka nas puno posla.
We're at a war with the demonic elements.
U ratu smo sa demonskim elementima.
And Maya.
I Majom.
And so we have to roll up our sleeves and each do our part.
Moramo zasukati rukave i svako mora napraviti svoj dio posla.
Most of you, me too, are older.
Većina vas, uključujući mene, smo stariji.
Why not spend the rest of our lives changing this world?
Zašto ne bismo ostatak života proveli u mijenjanju ovog svijeta?
The devotees are not meant to live in this world.
Bhakte nisu namijenjeni da žive u ovom svijetu.
We're here to change the world.
Mi smo tu da ga promijenimo.
But to do that we have to, but we cannot do that if we live the way everybody else lives.
Ali da bismo to učinili, ne možemo živjeti na isti način kako žive svi drugi.
Krishna has told us how to live.
Krishna nam je rekao kako živjeti.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam, everybody knows that sloka.
Om Purnam, Adam Purnam, i znaju li svi tu šloku?
Everything in this material world is perfect and complete.
Sve u ovom materijalnom svijetu je savršeno i potpuno.
Ishvasham Adam Sarvam. The Ishvasham principle.
Načelo Ishvasham.
Krishna is the owner of everything.
Krishna je vlasnik svega.
Everything.
Svega.
Including what we think we own.
Čak i onoga što mi mislimo da smo mi vlasnici.
And it's meant to be used in his service.
I to je namijenjeno da se koristi u njegovoj službi.
We are entitled to our quota, but not more.
Mi smo, dana nam je naša kvota, koliko nam treba, ali ne više od toga.
This is how we're supposed to be living.
I tako trebamo živjeti.
And Krishna said many times in Bhagavad Gita, don't be after the fruits of your activity.
I Krishna je rekao više puta u Bhagavad Giti, nemoj biti vezan za plodove svoga rada.
Those who want to enjoy the fruits of their work are misers.
Oni koji žele uživati u plodovima svoga rada su škrtice.
Don't be a miser.
Nemoj biti škrtica.
So we, you know, Krishna's given us, Prabhupada's given us everything that we need to do to live differently and to save this world.
Prabhupada nam je dao sve što nam treba da bismo živjeli drugačije i da bismo spasili ovaj svijet.
If we live differently, then people can see, oh, those people, they're doing something different. Maybe they can help us because we're really confused.
Ako budemo živjeli drugačije, onda će ljudi vidjeti, o, ovi žive drugačije, možda nam oni mogu pomoći jer mi smo stvarno zbunjeni.
People in this world are very bewildered.
Ljudi u ovom svijetu su unezvjereni.
They see what's going on in the world and they have no idea what to do.
Oni vide što se događa oko njih i nemaju pojma što da rade.
We know what to do.
Mi znamo što treba raditi.
But we have to demonstrate it.
Ali moramo to demonstrirati.
So, we give whatever we have.
Dajemo što god imamo.
Whatever money, possessions, land, ability.
Novac, posjed, zemlju, sposobnosti.
And we join together to do what Srila Prabhupada asks us to do.
I skupimo se kako bismo radili ono što je Srila Prabhupada nam rekao da trebamo raditi.
We live our philosophy.
Mi živimo svoju filozofiju.
What an idea.
Koja ideja.
So this is what I mean by starting the Hare Krishna movement again.
Na to mislim kad kažem ponovno pokretanje Hare Krishna pokreta.
Not against ISKCON.
Ne protiv ISKCON-a.
I don't want to spend any energy criticizing, thinking about what the GBC are doing or not doing.
Ne želim potratiti imalo energije na kritiziranje što ISKCON ili GBC rade.
I want to focus on what Srila Prabhupada told us to do.
Želim se fokusirati na ono što nam je Srila Prabhupada rekao da radimo.
And giving Krishna to the not yet devotees.
I da dajemo Krishnu onima koji još nisu bhakte.
Well, there's a lot of not yet devotees out there.
Ima, vani ima puno još ne bhakta.
They're waiting.
Oni
waiting for us to come.
Čekaju da mi dođemo.
So, we have work to do.
Imamo posla.
And we can create a spiritual revolution in this world.
I mi možemo stvoriti duhovnu revoluciju u ovom svijetu.
A revolution in the impious lives of a world's misdirected civilization.
Revoluciju u nepobožnim životima zavedene civilizacije.
Simply by following our acharya Srila Prabhupada.
Jednostavno sljedeći našeg acharyu Srila Prabhupada.
Srila Prabhupada ki?
Jai!
Hare Krishna. Okay, commentary, questions?
Komentari, pitanja?
Malo me ovo zainteresiralo što je Goswami rekao da obični ljudi mogu neke čak i velike stvari napraviti.
Prabhu says that he is very interested in what you said, that ordinary people can do extraordinary things.
To me podsjetilo kad sam bio Indije na Himalaja, u Gangotriju smo čekali našeg gurua da dođe. I sad su se bakte svi razbježali u grad da traže garland za gurua.
This reminds me of one story. We were in the Himalayas in Gangotri. We were waiting for our guru to come, so all the devotees went to town to search for a garland.
I kad su svi otišli, mada ne znam engleski niti jednu riječ, krenuo sam ja sam u grad, spustim se dole.
And when everybody left, I don't speak a single word of English, but I went to town on my own.
spustim se dole i sad razmišljam da vidim, možda ću negdje vidjeti cvijeće, cvjećaru kao što to kod nas na zapadu, pa da nađem, pa da dam napraviti garland, ali nisam vidio nigdje.
And I thought maybe I would see a florist somewhere like we have in the West, but I didn't see any.
A onda sam se sjetio dole kod rijeke Gange, dole ima neki hram, valjda od božanstva Gange, tako nešto, ne sjećam se više. Uglavnom vidio sam da su nekakve ponude na tanjuru sa cvjetićima puštali po Gangi.
And then I remembered that I saw that down near the Ganga there is a temple maybe dedicated to the Ganga, and they had offerings on like little boats with flowers, and they were releasing the boats onto the Ganga.
Onda sam otišao dolje. Nekako nije to veliki grad, otišao sam dolje, spustio se do rijeke i vidio sam da dole neki bakta ili ne znam brahmana neki slaže to isto te ponude, i ja sam ga zamolio da mi napravi garland. On meni ništa razumije, ja sam mu govorio hrvatski ovako i malo z rukama nešto.
So I went down to the Ganga and I met a person who was either a devotee or a brahmana, and he was arranging these offerings, and I tried to explain to him that I need a garland, and I talked in Croatian and with my arms and hands, but it didn't work.
Onda sam ja uzeo jedan cvijet i on sam mu pokazivao ovako oko vrata da mi napravi garland. I on je to shvatio, za čas je uzeo iglu i konce i počeo slagati.
Then I took a flower and I showed him like this, and he understood and started making a garland.
I napravio on garland, nije bilo on to skupo, ne znam, bilo 10 rupija ili koliko. Ja sam njemu dao i ja sretan nosim garland za guru, koji još nije došao, ali i treba doći. I sad smo mi to bili u toj srci da pripremimo garlande.
So it wasn't expensive, it was maybe 10 rupees, so I went to join the others and we were waiting for the guru to come.
I sad ja nosim garland i vraćam se natrag. I strašno mi je bilo, nisam se mogao vratiti više. To je bilo ono, nazovi hoteli, neki su bili gore ovako u brdo, stepenice neke drvene gore, idem po jednoj, vidim tu, pa nije to. Vraćam se natrag, idem drugi. Nije opet to. Sad sam već me panika ulovila da će se moći vratiti. Nigdje ne mogu ništa pročitati. Sve je to na onim hieroglifima nekim. Nemam pojma šta bi, kako da se snađem.
So he was going back up from the Ganga, and he he took wrong turns several times, and he couldn't read where he was because he can't read the script.
I od trećeg pokušaja uspijem doći gore, sav sretan, nosim garland.
And on the third attempt I managed to get up there.
Dođem ja unutra i vidim već guru sjedi, ja sam potrošio neko vrijeme u gradu, vidim guru već sjedi, ja dođem i nosim garland, ovi su skoro popadali dolje, bakte. Pa mi smo prošli cijeli Gangotri, nismo našli garland. Ti ne znaš ni jedne riječi, kako, gdje si našao garland?
So as I entered the building, the guru was already there. He was sitting down, and the other devotees, when they saw the garland, they were in shock and awe. They couldn't believe that I, who never spoke a word of English, could get a garland, and they couldn't.
Ja stavim guru garland, poklonim se, eto, to je bilo. I tako sam bio sretan, eto. Krishna mi je pomogao, ja sam nisam ništa znao, nisam, evo, jednostavno.
And then I gave guru the garland and paid my obeisances, and Krishna helped me, I couldn't do anything on my own.
By your desire.
Ti si to svojom željom ostvario.
You could do extraordinary things.
Mogao si to, mogao si napraviti izvanredne stvari željom.
To željom nisam.
I'll speak in Croatian then.
Okay.
Daću još malo kraći primjer koji još bolje ilustrira ovo što je Maharaj upravo sad govorio.
I will give a shorter example that illustrates maybe even better what you said right now.
Ima jedan bakta iz Osijeka kojim sam ja kao eto kao duhovni mentor, zove se bakta Milorad.
There is a devotee in Osijek in Croatia, his name is bakta Milorad. I'm sort of a mentor to him, sorry.
Sort of a mentor.
Spiritual mentor.
Advisor.
Okay.
On je 4 godine dolazio u hram i prije pola godine su mu autoriteti iz nekih čudnih razloga zabranili da dolazi u hram.
So he came to the temple for 4 years and 6 months ago the authorities forbade him from coming.
Ali on bio je povređen, ali nije odustao od toga da sve to ime dijeli sa drugima.
He was hurt, but he didn't give up sharing the holy name with others.
Savjetovao se sa mnom i on već mjesecima uzme harmoniju, ode sam tamo gdje je ona u zdravu, svira harmoniju.
We talked about this and he took my advice and he takes a harmonium next to the river Drava there and he plays it.
I ja sam mu napravio, tražim da mu napravim jedan letak sa jednim tekstom koji kad ga ljudi pitaju šta je to, onda ljudima da, to je jedan tako letak gdje sam ja stavio moj kontakt.
Mm-hmm. And he asked me to make him a flyer where it could be explained what he is playing and also Vrishabha's contact is on there.
And he's spreading holy name, independent of any authorities.
I on širi sveto ime neovisno o bilo kakvom autoritetu.
That's it.
Yeah. You don't need anybody's permission.
Ne trebate dopuštenje.
You have Lord Chaitanya's permission.
Imate dopuštenje gospodina Chaitanya.
Yeah.
Connecting with this example, I understand and know because I was preaching to the congregation and still doing. But the many people in congregation, many devotees in congregation are afraid that if we'll do something against the GPC authority, they will not either allow to come to the temple, to accept spiritual master, become initiated, etc. So how to solve this problem? Because many devotees feel that they need some recognition, identity within the movement.
Well, yeah.
Vezano uz to, ja propovjedam u kongregaciji i sada mnogi ljudi u kongregaciji se boje da ako će raditi nešto što nije odobreno od strane autoriteta, da će im biti zabranjeno da idu u hram ili neke druge stvari kao što smo čuli za inicijaciju i tako dalje.
It's not that they want recognition, they're concerned that they will lose the opportunity to come to kirtan, to see the deities, to have association.
Oni se brinu zapravo da neće moći doći na kirtan, da neće moći vidjeti božanstvo i da će izgubiti društvo bakta, a ne da im treba da ih neko prepozna.
Plus also, depending on how mature they are, they're... they may have the impression that the management authority is also spiritually advanced.
I ovisno o tome koliko su duhovno zreli, možda imaju dojam da je menadžerski autoritet, da su ti autoriteti zapravo duhovno zreli.
Neophyte devotees, they have no basis for understanding who's who.
Bakte početnici nemaju osnovu kako bi prepoznali tko je tko.
We get Prabhupada's books and we think that we go to the temple and the temple is going to be the manifestation of what we read in the books.
Mi uzmemo Srila Prabhupadove knjige i odemo u hram i mislimo da će hram biti otjelovljenje onoga što piše u Srila Prabhupadovim knjigama.
And if there's somebody there with the title or special position, sannyasi, guru, then, you know, they know a lot more than me. I should do what they say.
I ako je tamo neko s titulom ili s položajem, pogotovo ako je sannyasi i guru, mi mislimo on zna više, puno više od mene.
Okay, that's okay for neophytes.
To je okay za početnike.
But after 5, 6, 10 years, you develop some understanding and discrimination.
Ali nakon 5 do 10 godina razvijete neko razumijevanje i neku diskriminaciju, odnosno razlikovanje.
And attachment for Krishna consciousness.
I nekakvu privrženost za svjesnost Krishne.
And so if you're threatened with possibly losing that, it's a serious threat.
I ako vam neko prijeti s time da biste to mogli izgubiti, to je ozbiljna prijetnja.
And for most people it's enough to keep them in line.
I za većinu je to dovoljno da ih se drži u toru.
Now we have, let me give you some example from Slovenia.
Da vam dam primjer iz Slovenije.
No names, but neću, I don't remember names very well.
Neću vam reći imena jer se ne sjećam dobro imena.
So there are some devotees who were going out and creating home programs, and every week 20-30 people would come.
Neki bakte bi išli, radili bi kućne programe i svaki tjedan došlo bi 20-30 ljudi.
And the same thing, the temple authorities found out, oh, you're doing this independently.
I onda su hramski autoriteti saznali, vi to činite neovisno.
You're not authorized.
Vi niste ovlašteni.
Okay, well, authorize them.
Pa dobro, ovlastite ih.
But they don't.
Ali ne žele.
They stop it.
Oni su to zaustavili.
And they tell all the people who are hosting the programs, don't cooperate with that person, he's not authorized.
I svima koji su ugošćavali te programe kažu, nemojte surađivati s tom osobom, on nije ovlašten.
He's not doing anything wrong.
On ne čini ništa loše.
What's his fault?
Što je njegova krivica?
He's acting independently.
On djeluje neovisno.
Now, this implies that somebody wants control.
To implicira da netko želi kontrolu.
Control is a demonic propensity.
Kontrola je demonska sklonost.
Krishna gives everybody freedom.
Krishna daje svima slobodu.
Complete freedom.
Potpunu slobodu.
The demons want control.
Demoni žele kontrolu.
So why are we seeing this obsession with control in a spiritual organization?
Zašto vidimo tu obsesiju kontrolom u duhovnoj organizaciji?
That should tell us something.
To bi nam trebalo nešto govoriti.
My conclusion is where ISKCON again is infiltrated by the powers that be for the purpose of destroying Srila Prabhupada's mission from within.
Moj zaključak je da su se u ISKCON infiltrirale moći koje vladaju svijetom kako bi ga uništile iznutra.
And if anybody from ISKCON is watching this, I challenge you, go ahead and prove me wrong.
Ako me gleda neko iz ISKCON-a, odnosno sluša, ja vas izazivam. Dokažite da nisam u pravu.
Give up your control.
Odustanite od svoje kontrole.
We'll all be happier.
Svi ćemo biti sretniji.
What's the problem?
U čemu je problem?
Or as Srila Prabhupada put it, what is the difficulty?
Ili kao što je rekao Srila Prabhupada, u čemu je teškoća?
So, you know, I'm sorry, I can't personally come to any other conclusion.
Ja osobno ne mogu doći do nijednog drugog zaključka.
And it's, you know, this is my motivation to just create a non-institutional organization doing what Srila Prabhupada asked us to do.
I to je moja motivacija da napravimo neinstitucionaliziranu organizaciju i da radimo ono što nam je Srila Prabhupada rekao da radimo.
All of those who are afraid that they're going to get kicked out of ISKCON, they can leave together and create another temple where they have freedom.
Svi oni koji se boje da će ih izbaciti iz ISKCON-a, neka zajedno odu i neka naprave novi hram gdje će biti slobodni.
Many of those devotees are afraid, unfortunately.
Mnogi bakte se boje, nažalost.
Especially they're afraid to hear anything from Dhanesvara.
Pogotovo se boje čuti nešto od Dhanesvare.
What can you do?
A šta možete?
Što ako vidimo da neko djeluje neovisno, a ne radi u skladu sa Prabhupadinim učenjem?
What if we see that somebody acts independently but not following Srila Prabhupada?
There's a big world out there that there's billions of people doing that.
Postoji velik je svijet i milijarde ljudi rade to.
So?
Ali kao predstavlja se kao Prabhupada sljednik, recimo neko.
He presents himself as a Srila Prabhupada's follower to the others.
Yeah, okay, well, what can you do?
A šta možeš?
There's you can't control people.
Ne možeš kontrolirati ljude.
Okay. What I would suggest is you bless him.
Ja ti predlažem da mu daš blagoslov.
If you want to try to help them, the best thing to do is ask them questions.
Ako mu želiš pomoći, najbolje da mu postaviš pitanja.
Not accusations, questions.
Ne optužbe, nego pitanja.
My dear Prabhu, my understanding is Prabhupada wanted us to do this, but I see that you were doing something opposite of that. Can you explain to me?
Moj dragi Prabhu, moje razumijevanje je da je Srila Prabhupada htio da radimo ovo, a čini mi se da ti radiš nešto potpuno suprotno od toga. Možeš li mi objasniti?
Not with the idea of finding fault with them.
Ali ne s idejom da u njemu pronađeš nedostatke ili krivicu.
But to help them to be able to see what their own fault might be.
Nego da mu pomogneš da on sam vidi koji je njegov nedostatak.
And, you know, again, we can't control anybody. We can offer some help, some suggestion.
Mi ne možemo nikog kontrolirati, možemo ponuditi pomoć ili ponuditi neku sugestiju, prijedlog.
You know, there's people doing that within ISKCON.
Neki ljudi to rade unutar ISKCON-a.
They're not getting corrected somehow.
Ali ne ispravlja ih se iz nekog razloga.
Despite even a lot of public discussion about their situation.
Čak i unatoč tome što se puno u javnosti raspravlja o njihovom položaju.
So what's the difference inside ISKCON, outside ISKCON?
A koja je onda razlika unutar ISKCON-a ili izvan ISKCON-a?
Same thing.
I ista stvar.
Okay. Give them blessings and pray for them.
Daj im blagoslove i moli za njih.
There's one question from the crowd.
Okay.
If the Maharaj can explain why their emphasis and that the relation between why there is an emphasis between the relation between the Vaishnavas on that things which are different, instead of speaking or emphasizing that which should unite us. For example, even if within the same sampradaya, for example, ISKCON and Gaudiya Math. So why there is this emphasis? Makaraj je pitao po čega se podržava taj odnos među vaštamana, da nas razdvaja, ne ono što nas ujedinje, čak je to prisno i u primjeru različitih sampradaja, odnos ISKCON-a i Gaudiya Matha.
This is an example of neophyte behavior.
To je primjer početničkog, odnosno kako se zove? Početničko ponašanje. Da, kako se zove taj adikari?
Kaništa,
da.
Pardon. So, neophytes, their characteristic is they think they are the best devotee and everybody should be a devotee like them.
Karakteristika početnika ili kanište je da on misli da je on najbolji bakta i svatko treba biti bakta poput njega.
So, there's always going to be neophytes.
Uvijek će biti početnika.
And they create this sectarian division.
I oni stvaraju te sektaške podjele.
Which Srila Bhakti Siddhanta railed about.
O čemu je Srila Bhakti Siddhanta puno pričao.
The sectarian spirit destroys, you know, how did he put it? Anybody know? Sectarian spirit is destroying the preaching effort. Instead of uniting, we fight each other.
On je govorio da sektaški duh uništava napore propovjedanja, umjesto da surađujemo, mi se borimo jedni protiv drugih.
Now, there's another possibility here.
Postoji još jedna mogućnost ovdje.
And we see this being played out in the political arena all the time.
A vidimo to se stalno događa u politici.
That there's the powers that be, they want to create strife in the world and they pit one group against the other.
Oni koji su na vlasti žele održati vlast tako što postavljaju jedne protiv drugih, zavadi pa vladaj.
So they get some provocateur, you know, some Jewish provocateur to say bad things about the Muslims, and the Muslim provocateur to say bad things about the Jews.
I oni ubacuju provokatore na svaku stranu, znači židovski provokator govori negativno o muslimanima, muslimanski provokator negativno o židovima.
And pick any two groups in the world you want, the same thing's going on.
I odaberite koje god dvije grupe na svijetu hoćete, isti princip, ista stvar se događa.
And it could also be going on in the Vaishnav community.
I to se isto može i događati u Vaishnavskoj zajednici.
Could be, I don't know.
Možda, ne znam.
I mean, there's many different reasons why these things go on.
Postoji mnogo razloga zašto se takve stvari događaju.
Okay, where's that young man? Where did he go?
Here, here.
Igor, pitanje.
Samo zapita gdje
si. Tu sam. Pa dođi. Imaš pitanje, ne?
You have a question?
Ne, ne, pitanje.
You have to do something.
Imate pitanje, nisam.
Ok. Matiček. Ok.
Pa Prabhupada je rekao da će njegove knjige vrijediti 10.000 godina da bude vjerodostojne. A već nakon 5 godina, nakon njegovog odlaska su već počeli mijenjati. Kako to, mislim... Okay. Izjava, ne? Da li može malo pojasniti?
Could you clarify Srila Prabhupada's statement that he said that his books would be law for humankind, that they would be valid for 10,000 years, and they started changing the books after 5 years after he left this world. So can you explain that?
They were changing the books while Srila Prabhupada was with us.
Mm-hmm. Oni su mijenjali knjige već dok je Srila Prabhupada bio s nama.
He was furious.
On je bio bijesan.
He said, next printing, put it back to the original way.
I rekao je, u idućem štampanju stavite natrag kako je bilo.
So, why is it going on?
Zašto se to događa?
We're in a war.
Jer smo u ratu.
The demons have infiltrated our society.
Demoni su infiltrirali naše društvo.
Kamsa wants to destroy any appearance of the truth before he has time to develop.
Kamsa želi uništiti pojavljivanje istine prije nego što se ona stigne razviti.
Bhaktisiddhanta.
To je rekao Bhaktisiddhanta.
That's what's going on.
To se događa.
So each of us should make it our personal responsibility to preserve whatever original books, the most original books we have, because we don't know what's going to happen 200 years in the future.
I svako od nas treba preuzeti osobnu odgovornost da sačuvamo originalne knjige koliko god su bliske originalu koje imamo, jer ne znamo što će se dogoditi za 200 godina.
Get a set of even the original English books, even if you can't read them, preserve them for the future.
Nabavite set izvornih engleskih knjiga, čak i ako ne znate engleski, i samo ih čuvajte za budućnost.
We have a duty to protect posterity.
Mi imamo dužnost da štitimo one koji dolaze kasnije.
That's how this book began.
I na taj način je započeta ova knjiga.
I was reading about the followers of Jesus from the Dead Sea Scrolls and Nag Hammadi text.
Čitao sam o sljedbenicima Iskona, o Isusa sa svitaka, mrtvomorskih svitaka i Nag Hammadi tekstova.
Those 2000 years ago, they understood that there were demonic elements who were destroying scripture. They wanted to preserve their knowledge, their truth, and so they wrote it on scrolls, they put it in jars, and they hid it in caves and in the earth.
Prije 2000 godina ljudi su razumjeli da demonske sile žele uništiti spise i onda su oni pisali na svitke, stavili ih u staklenke i sakrili ih, zakopali ih u zemlju i sakrili ih u špilje.
They were discovered around 1950.
I otkrivene su oko 1950.
Okay. One of the scholars that I quote in this book, he gave an honest translation of those scriptures.
I jedan od učenjaka kojeg spominjem u ovoj knjizi, on je dao iskren prijevod tih svitaka.
And from them we learn that Jesus and his followers were devotees exactly like us.
I iz njih saznajemo da su Isus i njegovi sljedbenici bili bakte baš poput nas.
They followed four regulative principles.
Slijedili su četiri regulativna principa.
They wore tilak.
Nosili su tilak.
They glorified the names of God.
Slavili su Božje ime.
They had a masculine and feminine deity.
Imali su muško i žensko božanstvo.
Their cleanliness habits were exactly the same as ours.
Imali su iste navike održavanja čistoće kao i mi.
They would not associate with non-devotees,
ne bi se, their kind. Ne bi se družili sa abaktama, odnosno ljudima drugačijim od sebe.
They were convinced that their scripture was changed and it was the duty of Jesus to correct scripture and to reestablish the principles of religion.
Oni su vjerovali da su njihovi spisi izmijenjeni i Isusova dužnost je da ponovno uspostavi religiju onakvu kakva treba biti.
Anyway, if I read those characteristics to you and ask you who are these people, you're probably going to say those are the Hare Krishnas.
Yeah.
Ako vam samo kažem te karakteristike bez da vam kažem ko su ti ljudi, vi ćete misliti pa to su Hare Krishna.
So if Jesus and his followers were like us, what happened?
Ako su Isus i njegovi sljedbenici bili poput nas, što se dogodilo?
Because Christianity is not anything like Vaishnavism.
Jer kršćanstvo sada ne sliči vajšnavizmu.
So that begs the question.
Otuda dolazi pitanje.
What's Hare Krishna going to be like in 2000 years?
Kakva će biti Hare Krishna za 2000 godina?
Or 200 years?
Ili 200 godina?
Depends on what we do.
Ovisi o tome što ćemo mi uraditi.
Okay. That's the reason I started the book with that history from 2000 years ago.
I zato sam započeo knjigu sa tom povijesnom pričom od prije 2000 godina.
Because I've seen in my 50 years they're dealing with ISKCON exactly as they dealt with the what I call Jewish Vaishnavas from 2000 years ago.
Jer sam ja u svojih 50 godina u ISKCON-u vidio da se oni prema ISKCON-u ponašaju na isti način na koji su se ponašali prema takozvanim židovskim vajšnavama prije 2000 godina.
It's a war.
To je rat.
We have to understand we're in a war.
Moramo razumjeti da smo u ratu.
Don't forget it.
Nemojte to zaboraviti.
And when you see some problem, first thing you can think of is this because we're in a war?
I kad vidite neki problem, trebate se zapitati je li to zato što smo u ratu.
Now, if you're in a war, you do things to protect your group.
Ako si u ratu, radiš stvari da zaštitiš svoju grupu.
Everyone does.
Svako to radi.
So every one of us have a responsibility to protect the legacy of Srila Prabhupada.
I svako od nas ima odgovornost da zaštiti baštinu Srila Prabhupada.
That means principally preserve his original books.
A to prvenstveno znači očuvati njegove izvorne knjige.
Okay.
Ste u svojoj lekciji govorili kako je danas veliki utjecaj demona.
You talked in your lecture how today there's a big influence of demons.
Yeah.
Ja sam na lekcijama slušam da je biti materijalni svijet neprestani sukob demonskih odlika i božanskih odlika i da su i demoni pod kontrolom Krišne.
I hear in lectures that the material world is a constant clash of demonic and divine.
The Asuras and the Devas.
Yeah? Yeah. And that the demons are also under the control of Krishna.
I, ali isto tako i na lekcijama i u Srila Prabhupadovim knjigama smo čitali da je i sam Krishna izjavljuje kada god dolazi do povećanja demonskih utjecaja, ja se pojavljujem da bi uništio demone i zaštitio bakte. I jednostavno iz toga, pa zašto bi se onda brinula o tom tako velikom demonskom utjecaju kad je i on pod kontrolom Krišne?
I also hear in lectures and read in Bhagavad Gita that Krishna says wherever there is a rise in irreligion, I appear to deal with it. Yes. So why would I worry then? Because even the demons are under the control of Krishna.
And Krishna says, Krishna kaže da se on pojavljuje.
And he, Krishna says that he appears to protect the devotees and destroy the miscreants.
So are you under the control of Krishna?
Yes, in the tip of control of Krishna.
I think I am.
Ja mislim da jesam.
Do you ever do anything wrong?
Da li ikad napraviš nešto krivo?
Oh, I do.
Is that Krishna's fault because he's controlling you?
Ja to Krishna kriv jer on te kontrolira.
That's very tricky.
To je tricky. Zeznuto.
No.
We have free will.
Free will. I have my own free will.
Mi imamo slobodnu volju.
The demons have free will.
Demoni imaju slobodnu volju.
They hate God.
Oni mrze Boga.
We read Srimad Bhagavatam.
Mi čitamo Srimad Bhagavatam. Right?
What's Kamsa want to do? He wants to destroy Krishna. He wants to kill all the babies in Vrindavan to try to destroy Krishna.
I što Kamsa želi učiniti? On želi uništiti Krishnu i zato ubija sve bebe u Vrindavanu da bi ubio Krishnu.
Kamsa and Putna, what we're reading from Bhaktisiddhanta.
Kamsa i Putana, ono što smo čitali od Bhaktisiddhante.
So they have free will, we have free will.
Oni imaju slobodnu volju, mi imamo slobodnu volju.
Battle of Kurukshetra, everybody had free will.
Na Kurukshetri svi su imali slobodnu volju.
And Krishna told Arjuna, it's already decided, but you have to fight.
I Krishna je rekao Arjuni, već je odlučeno, ali ti se moraš boriti.
So yes, Krishna comes whenever there's the demonic get out of control.
Da, Krishna se pojavljuje kad god demoni izađu izvan kontrole, odnosno previše ojačaju.
So, how has he appeared?
I kako se on pojavlja?
In Kali Yuga, how does Krishna appear?
U Kali Yugi, kako se Krishna pojavlja?
Mahaprabhu.
Like his name.
What?
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his name, Hare Krishna Mahamantra.
Yeah, exactly.
Kao Chaitanya Mahaprabhu i kao Mahamantra.
So, whenever we say Hare Krishna, Krishna is there.
Kad god kažemo Hare Krishna, Krishna se pojavljuje.
How much are we saying Hare Krishna enough?
Ali govorimo li Hare Krishna dovoljno?
We need more Hare Krishna.
Trebamo više Hare Krishna.
I'll tell you a little anecdote.
Ispričat ću vam malu anegdotu.
I explained to you the situation in America in the 60s when Prabhupada came.
Objasnio sam vam situaciju u 60-ima kad je Prabhupada došao.
When Prabhupada left by 1977, all of those problems had gone away.
Kad je Prabhupada napustio ovaj svijet 77. Svi ti problemi su nestali. Nije ih bilo.
After Prabhupada left, they started coming back.
Ali nakon što je on otišao, ti problemi su se vratili.
Personally, I give credit to Srila Prabhupada's presence and the devotees very actively doing Harinam, distributing books, and carrying on the war with Maya.
Ja dajem zasluge za to Srila Prabhupadovoj prisutnosti i baktama koji su se vrlo aktivno angažirali u bici protiv Maje.
Now, nobody can see the connection between the two. Nobody can say, oh, those Hare Krishnas, they changed our world.
Niko ne vidi poveznicu između te dvije stvari. Niko ne kaže, o, ti Hare Krishna, oni su promijenili naš svijet.
But we understand, Krishna's present in his name, in all of his potency.
Ali mi razumijemo, Krishna je prisutan u svom imenu u svim, sa svim svojim moćima.
So, we need more Hare Krishna.
Znači, trebamo više Hare Krishna.
Okay. Hare Nam Sankirtan?
Ki jai.
Dhanesvara Goswami ki
jai.
Hare Krishna. Young man. What? Something more?
Još nešto?
Pita da li ima tamo nešto na...
Another question here?
Yeah, I don't know.
Ima li netko pitanje od vas?
Ja, 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 ja.
Zoom.
Zoom ekipa.
Ako su mutirali, ne možete.
Možete se unmutat, odnosno odstišat.
Odstišat. I can just
imagine. Prabhu has a question.
Maharaj, hvala lijepa na prekrasnoj inspirativnoj lekciji i odgovorima.
Thank you very much for beautiful inspiring lecture and answers.
Ja bih htio ne da kažeš svoje mišljenje, ali ja bih htio izneti nešto slušajući tebe. Htio bih spomenuti jedan konkretan tijek i događaja koje sam ja prošao u svom duhovnom životu.
I would like to share a course of events that I have gone through in my spiritual life.
Oh, please.
Situacija u Zagrebu zadnjih 10 godina je dešavala se točno onako kako si ti opisao, kao da si skenirao u svakom koraku. To se dešavalo u Zagrebu i to se sada dešava u Zagrebu.
It is like you scanned every step of what was happening in Zagreb in the last 10 years and is still happening.
Navešu jedan primjer.
For example?
Situacija je bila teška, tempel je praktički zadnjih 5-6 godina prazan, osim par bhakta sankirtan.
The temple is practically empty for the last 5 or 6 years except for a few sankirtan devotees.
Određene bhakte su izazvale raskol u našoj zajednici.
Certain devotees have caused a schism within our community.
Podržane GBC-em.
They are supported by GBC.
I onda je situacija da je tempel praktički prazan, svi standardi božanstava su smanjeni na minimum.
So the temple is practically empty and all the deity standards have been lowered to the minimum.
Kongregacija se organizirala u Zagrebu koji je glavni grad, dakle ima milion stanovnika Zagreb.
Zagreb is our capital and it has about a million inhabitants and congregation have organized themselves.
Bakte su napravili prijedlog kompletne brige oko božanstava i svih i održavanja templa.
And then they made a plan, a suggestion how they could care about the deities and how they could maintain the temple, the congregation.
Oni bi to radili i službom i podopirajući financijski sve.
They would do it by service and by Lakshmi, by their money.
I to je program je donesen, sve smo organizirali u detalje.
And everything was organized up to the last detail.
I onda smo to predložili temple commanderu.
And we suggested this to the temple commander.
A on je to predložio GBC-u.
And he suggested this to the GBC.
To je bilo prije, ne mogu reći, negdje prije 3 godine, 4.
That was 3 or 4 years ago.
I GBC je to glatko, a totalno odbio prijedlog.
And the GBC just refused it, like that.
Da to templu nije potrebno, da nije važno obožavanje božanstava, da je najvažniji sankirtan.
The temple doesn't need that, deity worship is not important, sankirtan is of utmost importance.
Situacija se pogoršavala iz godine u godinu.
The situation was getting worse year to year.
Prošle godine ponosno smo napravili zajednički program i ponudili suradnju templu.
Last year we made a joint program with them and offered the temple our cooperation.
Bez nekakvih posebnih uvjeta, samo da služimo i da održavamo božanstva, da podignemo standard.
With no special conditions, just to serve the deities and to lift the standard.
Sunday feastovi su ukinuti između mnogo drugih loših odluka.
Sunday feasts, among other bad decisions, have been cancelled.
U templu je određeno radno vrijeme, samo možeš ući u templu vrijeme radnog vremena.
So the temple has working hours and outside of those working hours you cannot go there.
I GBC-u je donesen taj novi prijedlog o suradnji.
and the GBC was presented with this new suggestion for cooperation.
I onda njegov, o njegov odgovor je, ne mogu reći od riječi do riječi, ali skraćeno rečeno, pojednostavljeno, on je rekao, pa zašto ste vi, šta ste vi, zašto ste toliko zainteresirani za tempel, tempel je samo zgrada. Pa vi sebi napravite neki svoj program vlastiti, pa ćemo vidjeti onda vi se kao maloj djeci, vi se tamo negdje igrajte, pa ćemo vidjeti šta će biti.
And the GBC said, in short, why are you so interested in the temple? The temple is just a building. You do your own program somewhere else. Like he was saying to little children, go play somewhere
else. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Palananda Swami. That's what exactly what I'm trying to do. Why is he saying, don't listen to Dhanesvara? I want to do what he wants to do.
Hvala ti, Praladananda Swami. Ja upravo to pokušavam i činiti. Zašto onda kaže, ne slušajte Dhanesvaru? Ja želim učiniti to što on vama naređuje da činite.
Hare Krishna, makes you want to cry.
Hare Krishna, poželite zaplakati o tome.
And I'm sure many of you have been crying.
I siguran sam da su mnogi od vas i plakali.
Okay, good. Let's do that. Let's open another temple.
Ok, ajmo to napraviti, ajmo otvoriti još jedan hram.
Without GBC.
Bez GBC.
We don't need their permission.
Ne trebamo njihovu dozvolu.
Ok, if any of you are serious about doing that, I'll stay here and help.
Ako je bilo ko od vas ozbiljan u tom naumu, ja ću ostati ovdje i pomoći.
Ok. Let me know.
Javite mi.
Hare Krishna. Well, Hi. It's I want to thank Prahladananda Swami.
Želim zahvaliti Prahladananda Swamiju
for opposing me.
Što se bori protiv mene.
You know, when somebody's opposing you, you fight back with more determination.
Kad se neko bori protiv tebe, onda se ti boriš sa većim žarom.
So Prahladananda Swami, keep it up.
Dakle, Prahladananda Swami, samo nastavi.
What a world.
Hare Kaka Krishna. Svijet. Hare Krishna.
Okay. Hare Krishna, Praj. There is one question from one devotee in Zoom chat.
Harusha, go ahead. Okay. As you can hear.
Hoćeš na hrvatski pa da... Možete prevesti to ono. Reći šta je to pitanje bilo ono. Ko je imao pitanje na chatu ono?
Again, sam imala pitanje.
Možeš ponoviti to, možda.
Pa, te minima trađi ima pitanje.
Ajde, recite samo uživo kad skačeš.
How to recognize the demons among the devotees?
Kako prepoznati?
And do they recognize him or them? What to do?
Kako?
What to do?
Kako prepoznati demone među baktama i kada ih prepoznamo, što učiniti?
Very good question.
Jako dobro pitanje.
Srila Prabhupada has answered this question for us.
Srila Prabhupada nam je odgovorio na to pitanje.
One cannot understand who is a deva and who is an asura simply by looking at them.
Osoba ne može raspoznati devu i asuru jednostavno gledajući ih.
So many demons dress in a suit and tie.
Demoni se oblače u odjela i kravate.
They look like nice people.
Izgledaju kao fini ljudi.
How do we understand?
A kako onda razumjeti?
You have to judge by their activities.
Trebate prosuditi po njihovim aktivnostima.
In other words, falena paričijete.
Drugim riječima, falena paričijete.
Judging by the result of their activities, you can know who is who.
Sudeći po rezultatima njihovih aktivnosti, možete znati tko je tko.
Now there are many quotes from Srila Prabhupada where he says there are many people in this Krishna consciousness movement with an ulterior motive.
Postoje mnogi citati od Srila Prabhupada gdje on kaže postoje mnogi ljudi u ovom pokretu sa nižim motivima.
And here's a quote from the back of my book.
A ovo je sa poleđine moje knjige.
There are many jealous people in the dress of Vaishnavas in this Krishna consciousness movement and they should be completely neglected.
Postoje mnogi ljubomorni ljudi u odjeći Vaišnava u ovom pokretu za svjesnost Krišne i treba ih se u potpunosti zanemariti.
He doesn't qualify that by saying this doesn't apply to the GBC.
No.
On ne kaže to se ne odnosi na GBC.
So, they should be completely neglected. That's, I'm simply following Prabhupada's instruction. That's what we should do.
Treba ih u potpunosti zanemariti. Ja jednostavno slijedim Šila Prabhupadovu instrukciju i to trebamo svi raditi.
And how do we deal with them?
A kako se nositi s njima?
We offer them respect from a distance.
Ponudimo im svoje poštovanje sa distance.
Very simple. We don't get close to them, we don't listen to them, we don't allow them to influence us.
Znači, ne slušamo ih i ne dopuštamo im da vrše utjecaj nad nama.
And even we should give them blessings.
Možemo im čak dati blagoslove.
There's another instruction from Srila Bhakti Siddhanta. One should wish nothing but the highest good for their enemies.
Srila Bhakti Siddhanta je rekao, ne treba željeti ništa osim najvećeg dobra za svoje neprijatelje.
Well, I don't consider them enemies, but we should wish them only the highest good.
Ja ih ne smatram neprijateljima, ali treba im poželjeti samo najveće dobro.
Ok.
Je li to u redu?
Ok, trećemo.
Neko pitanje s četa, nek se javimo.
Ima li još neko pitanje na četu?
Ja bih htio nešto još reći, može?
Može.
Mislim da će to biti interesantno čuti jedan podatak Maharadžu.
I would like to say something else. I think this information will be interesting for you.
Prije negdje oko 150 godina u Srbiji su bili jedna porodica koji su se zvali Taradići. Oni su bili vidoviti.
About 150 years ago, there was a family in Serbia, which is a neighboring country. The family last name was Taradić, and they were all psychic. They had clairvoyance.
You all know this history.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Da, Maharaj možda znao to već.
Do you already know this?
No, I do not. But I'm very curious to hear it.
Još ne znam, ali me zanima.
Taj Tarabić je bio nepismen.
This Tarabić guy was illiterate.
A svećenik, njegov rođak, je zapisivao to što je govorio. Jer on je pričao koje kakve gluposti, čudnovate stvari.
But his cousin, who was a priest, he wrote down what this guy said, because he said all sorts of nonsense and weird things.
I on je pričao vrlo jednostavnim jezikom. On je rekao, u budućnosti, kaže, to će biti kada se rodi od tvog djeteta, od djeteta, od djeteta, onda će doći će doba, pojavit će se jedan mali čovjek.
And he spoke in very simple language, and he said, in the future, when your child's child's child is born, then in the future a very short man will appear.
Mali čovjek, on je rekao mali, što je interesantno.
A small man, a short man. And that's interesting.
I on će doneti znanje i proširit će ga po cijelome svijetu, znanje koje nitko nikada prije nije donio.
And he will bring knowledge and spread it all across the world, the knowledge that has not been brought by anyone else before.
I rekao, a prepoznat će se po tome zato što će na čelu imati znak.
And you will recognize him by having a sign on his forehead.
Njegovi sljedbenici će nositi isti takav znak na čelu.
And his followers will wear the same sign on their foreheads, a symbol.
I neki će se čuditi, ali većinom ljudi neće moći prepoznati mnogi neće moći prepoznati to znanje.
Many, some will be astonished, but many will not recognize this knowledge.
I kaže, imat će sljedbenike po cijelome svijetu.
And he will have followers all around the world.
Ali, nažalost, kaže, imat će u svojim sljedbenicima i puno prijetvorica.
But among his followers, there will be many who are fake, who are deceivers.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Wow,
wonderful.
Yeah,
very accurate.
Vrlo točno.
Okay, it's getting late, so
we
should stop. I want to thank all of you here and all of you on Zoom for participating, for coming to hear.
Hvala vam svima na Zoomu i svima koji ste ovdje, što ste sudjelovali i došli slušati.
And I want you to know that I'm very serious. If we can start something here, I'll come here and stay here and do my part.
I želim da znate da sam jako ozbiljan i ako želite pokrenuti nešto ovdje, ja ću doći ovdje i ostati ovdje i napravit ću svoj dio.
I'll initiate devotees without the approval of the GBC.
Inicirat ću bakte bez odobrenja GBC-a.
And the disciples won't need the approval of the GBC either.
I ti učenici neće trebati odobrenje GBC-a.
And we will have freedom.
I imat ćemo slobodu.
Okay, spiritual revolution.
Ki jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai.
Hare Krishna.
Ki
jai.
Maharaj, can I tell something short?
Okay, go ahead.
Mogu li ispričati nešto kratko?
Moj guru Maharaj, Bhaktisiddha Swami. U ostrovu dolje kad smo bili, pričao je nama nekolicini zapravo situaciju, kaže, napomenuo je, takva situacija je u instituciji, da u instituciji ima i nacionalizma, i seksizma, i ovoga...
That's the translate.
Rasizma, dobro.
Okay, my Guru Maharaj Bhakti Tirtha Swami, when we were in camp, in a retreat in Rt Ostro, he said that there is nationalism, racism, and all kinds of isms within the institution.
Of ISKCON?
Yes.
I kaže, to vam govorim zbog toga da ne budete zatečeni, jer ćete se sa tim, ovoga, sa svim tim ćete se ovoga susreti.
And I'm telling you this so you are not surprised, because you will see all these things.
I onda je rekao da rekao je svoj primjer.
He said,
da je otišao na sastanak GBC-a.
And he said his example, that he went to a GBC meeting.
I neki članovi ovoga GBC-a nisu se mogli suzdržati i rekli su šta taj majmun radi ovdje, što ne ide u Afriku?
And some members of the GBC said, what is this monkey doing here? Why isn't he in Africa?
Any devotee who's truthful and honest, they want to discourage and make them feel bad.
Svakog iskrenog baktu oni žele obeshrabriti i žele da se osjeća loše.
Gorgovinda Swami also.
Gorgovinda Swami također.
Okay, continue.
I rekao je, i onda on je rekao, ja sam to čuo. Rekao, ja sam to čuo i nasmiješio sam se prema, na tu stranu, prema njima, pozdravio i zauzeo svoje mjesto ovoga gore, tamo di je.
And he said, I heard this, I smiled at them and I just took my seat.
Yeah. Okay, not surprised. Thank you very much. I'm sure everybody has a testimonial. You know, it would be nice if you have some example of what I'm talking about tonight. Please write it down and send it to Rishabh.
Hvala vam puno. Siguran sam da svako ima neko takvo iskustvo. I ako imate takva iskustva kao što smo danas pričali, molim vas, zapišite to i pošaljite Rishabhi.
Moja email adresa je vpd108@gmail.com. Znači vpd108.
Dajemo na grupu.
Ja bi još nešto sam dodao. Tu je ovaj baktar, dan sedam, blizu Riši, jako bolestan, pa ako je mogli nekoliko mahamantri za njega izgovoriti.
Okay. There is a devotee who lives nearby who is very, very ill, so if we could say a couple of mahamantras for him.
Oh. Sure. Okay. Okay, so what's his name?
Rishikunda.
Rishikunda. So, dear Krishna, please give Rishikunda our blessing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Okay, thank you again very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.